Issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria, and everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea to Bethlehem to the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no guest room available for them. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloths and lying in a manger."
Well, I'd like to introduce our first soloist this evening. And it's a piece called So Glad, published by the Salvation Army. It's a composition by William Hines. And to play it for you, please welcome Simon Skeppenberg.
Thank you. one is from the book of the prophet Isaiah, written 750 years before Christ. But it's worth just realising when Isaiah was writing, he was writing in a nation that had had a row over sovereignty and was split into two over the issue. Does this sound familiar? There was an oppressive power who wouldn't let his plan go forward, and his king was in political gridlock. Does this sound familiar? And yet Isaiah, looking 750 years into the future, saw a solution, and this is what he said. Unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace, there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish this. When we look over into the New Testament, there was an argument between Jesus and an intellectual one night. And Jesus said to this guy, I tell you the truth, unless a man is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. How can a man be born when he's old? Nicodemus asked. Surely he can't enter a second time into his mother's womb. Jesus answered, I tell you the truth, unless a man is born of water and the Spirit, he cannot see or enter the kingdom of God. For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Thanks be to God for his word.
Thank you. sitting here tonight. I'm just going to take 5 minutes every time now. I'm not going to say anything that's not already been said or sung. But we're just going to go through what it is, what the hope of Christmas. And I'm going to read a few verses from Luke chapter 1 verse. And it says, "My soul glorifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Saviour. For he has been mindful of the humble state of his servant. From now on all generations will call me blessed, for the mighty one has done great things for me. Holy is his name." So, we're here tonight, obviously, to celebrate Christmas. What does that mean? What does that mean, really? You know, for each one of us, as we go home, you know, look around you, look to your personal experience. Christmas means a lot of things now. You know, especially, I've got young children now, a lot of people in here have families, grandchildren maybe. And Christmas is a time for family. Yeah, Christmas is a time for family and friends, seeing people that we wouldn't normally see. Christmas is a time for giving and receiving gifts. Christmas is a time for indulgence, maybe. Eating, drinking. Christmas is a time for the Queen's speech. Christmas can be a very expensive time. Yeah, some people get worried about that. Christmas can easily cost a lot of money. Most of us in here will see Christmas from our armchairs in our warm houses, you know, surrounded by loved ones. And that's our view of Christmas. But what about the rest of the world? You know, the hope that we are talking about, you know, the Christian church represents hope to the whole world, to all people. You know, so a week on Tuesday when we're sitting around our dining room table full of turkey, pulling crackers and drinking sherry, that might not look like hope to some people in the darker corners of the world. You know, some of the darker corners of Stoke-on-Trent, even. So what is the hope of Christmas? You know what does look like hope? We've heard it a lot tonight. The birth of Christ, our Lord and Saviour. Yeah, some of the songs that we've sung tonight, we're very familiar with them, but the words and the lyrics are absolutely awesome. Yeah, Jesus Christ coming to the earth, stepping into our world. That is hope. Yeah, and that does shine light into the darkest corners of the world. Because there will be a lot of people at Christmas that have no family, that have no turkey, maybe that have no hope. You know, some people all over the world, some people right on our doorstep that for various reasons will not enjoy the same experience of Christmas as we do. But thank God tonight that there is hope. The message of Christmas is this, is that God is our creator and he loves us. We are separated from our creator by the things that we do and the way that we live our lives. We can never bridge that separation by ourselves. We have a creator that loves us and he wants us to love him back. But by ourselves we can't do that. You know, God desires us. God loves us, and he has an eternal place prepared for us in his glorious presence. You know, we look at Christmas, the material side of it that we can get so wrapped up in. Listen, you know, any material thing that we can have in this earth, any pleasure or experience that we could have, will fade away one day. But nothing will compare to the glory of heaven and the great inheritance that God has for each one of us. You know, like we've said, the great tragedy is that we have blown our chances. You know, we've all fallen short of that standard. We're all cut off from the presence of God. There's nothing that we can do in our own strength to reverse that. We can never earn our way to heaven. And so this is the great hope of Christmas. You know, that's the position that we're in. The hope of Christmas is that God provides a way for us. and that way is Jesus Christ. Yeah? The Son of God, born into this world to live a perfect life. He went through life, he went through the same trials and troubles as we do, to live a life that completely deserves that eternal place in heaven. And so we all know the story. Jesus was an innocent man, and yet he was punished and killed on a cross in a terrible way. But why? What does that mean? All the sins that we've ever committed, all the things that we've ever done in our lives that were dishonest or hurtful, everything, even down to the thoughts of anger that we sometimes have against one another, these are the things that have cut us off from God. It doesn't matter how big or small our sins are, it's already too late. But Jesus Christ lives a perfect life on this earth, and he earns the right to stand in heaven with the Father. He meets that perfect standard. But it was the will of God that our sins be placed on Jesus, and that Jesus takes our sins to the cross. And he died, and he was cut off, and he was separated from God on our behalf. And so if Jesus takes my sin, that gives me a way back to God. That bridges the gap and gives me a second chance. And that gives me an amazing hope that goes far beyond this world. And so that is really what tonight is about. You know, we praise and we worship him for that hope. Yeah? Christmas time, we remember Jesus Christ born as a little baby. But believe me now, he is not a little baby. He is the glorified Son of God. He lived and he died for me. And he rose again, and he's glorified, and he still stands for me. I just want to read that verse again from the Gospel of Luke. And it's Mary speaking. You know, most of us are probably quite familiar with that. But Mary is a young girl, and she's nobody special, really. She's not rich. She's not important in her town or anything. You know, nothing that would really make her stand out from the crowd. And I wish I had time tonight to go through some of the amazing details, some of the things that happened around the birth of Jesus, the fulfillment of some of the promises and prophecies. You know, the way that God planned it out was absolutely fantastic. The greatest story in the history of the world, the series of events that would change the course of history, would start with this young girl. And so she says, "My soul glorifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Saviour. For he has been mindful of the humble state of his servant. And from now on, all generations will call me blessed, for the mighty one has done great things for me. Holy is his name." So you know what, this Christmas time there will be people with no families, you know? People in bad states and situations, sleeping in bus shelters or worse than that. Maybe some people sitting here tonight are thinking, you know, life is pretty rough, and the message of hope this Christmas seems to have bypassed you. Listen, Jesus Christ is our Lord and Saviour, and he stands today in power, with fire in his eyes. He is the eternal King of the universe. And he was born, listen to me, in a cow trough. Yeah? Jesus knows. He sees where you are. He knows all about it. And the hope that he has for you goes far beyond anything that this world could ever give you. So Christmas is a message of hope for you this year. However rich or poor you are by the standards of this world, put your hope in Jesus.
Thank you. Thank you.